Terms funding organizations or funding agencies refers to any public or private fund giving or granting organizations agencies which provide funding to non-governmental organizations. This lesson is about national and international funding organizations. Objectives. On completion of this lesson, you would know about various national and international funding organizations. Funding organizations. Funding organizations include foundations, corporations, charity organizations, trust, etc. Funding organizations that support funding can be national or international. It can be private, from public and developmental sectors. Fundraising is one of the important activities of in the development sector or with the non-government organization. The NGO or non-profit sector spend much time and energy on mobilizing funds to meet the increasing needs or demands of the community with scarce resources. Each organization devises its own plan, patterns and processes for raising funds for social welfare activities, services or activities. The sustainable way of functioning of non-governmental organization is raising regional or local funds and includes all stakeholders. Fundraising is the act of getting financial support, usually in the form of money, to finance a program, service, project, usually by non-governmental organizations. Non-governmental organizations and fundraising. Most non-governmental organizations, especially social welfare organizations, acquire funds from funding agencies. Depending on their area of work, such as child welfare, women welfare, welfare of disabled, research, religious, disaster management, relief work, etc. These organizations can apply for funds from funding agencies that support those causes. There are many national and international funding agencies, donors, philanthropy groups, charity organizations which provide financial support to non-governmental organizations working in the areas of social welfare and social services. The funding agencies and grant supporters provide funds according to their guidelines, terms and conditions in certain pre-decided parameters. Most of the funding organizations provide funding to grassroots level NGOs who really work for social sector, social causes and entrepreneurship and associated with welfare programs. Details of some important national and international funding agencies. ActionAid. ActionAid is an international non-government organization whose primary aim is to work against poverty and injustice worldwide. ActionAid is a federation of 45 country offices that works with communities, often via local partner organizations, on a range of development issues. It was founded in the year 1972 by C.L. Jackson Cole as a child sponsorship charity, originally called as Action in Distress, when 88 UK supporters sponsored 88 children in India and Kenya. The primary focus ActionAid is providing children with an education, further the human rights for all, assisting people that are in poverty, assisting those who face discrimination, and also assist people who face injustice. ActionAid works with over 15 million people in 45 different countries to assist those people. ActionAid integrates women's rights into all of its programming and project work, but also undertakes campaigns that focus specifically on these issues. ActionAid promotes women's leadership in humanitarian responses, arguing that women are best positioned to identify their needs and those of the communities around them in times of crisis. ActionAid's advocacy work on climate change focuses on climate justice, guided by the experiences and needs of its country programs. Its most prominent engagement comes through the annual conference of parties, where it supports communities vulnerable to climate change to influence decision-making processes. As it has established relationship with communities and other NGOs in countries that are prone to ecological events, ActionAid is often able to respond quickly to emergencies. Notable crises and responses have included the tsunami in 2010. This support takes the form of providing clean water, healthcare, agriculture programs, education centers in the areas where schools are not available, and community income generation schemes. ActionAid India is an official children's rights NGO believing in a world without poverty and injustice in which every child enjoys the right to dignity. Aga Khan Foundation. Aga Khan Foundation is a private funding agency established by Aga Khan in Switzerland in 1967. It is operational in country, implementing a range of programs in diverse fields from water and sanitation to maternal health and family nutrition, sustainable agriculture to a disaster risk reduction and response, cultural restoration to school improvement. The Aga Khan Foundation established first school in Mundra, Gujarat. Today, its geographic areas of focus include the states of Bihar, Delhi, Gujarat, Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra, Uttar Pradesh, and Telangana. These initiatives include schools and educational centers, hospital, rural support programs that are benefited over 1.5 million people in over 2,500 villages across the state of Gujarat, Madhya Pradesh, and Bihar, and the restoration of World Heritage Site in the nation's capital. American India Foundation. The American India Foundation, founded in the year 2001 by a group of Indian Americans responding to the 2001 Gujarat earthquake, is a non-profit American organization that is devoted to accelerating social and economic change in India. American India Foundation has partnered with 227 of India's NGOs to build a trusted network of implementation, scale and sustainable while raising over $84 million since its inception. It is one of the largest secular, non-partisan American organizations supporting development work in India. American India Foundation awards grants to education, livelihood and public health projects in India, with emphasis on elementary education, women's empowerment and HIV/AIDS respectively. American India Foundation has a program called Digital Equalizer, which attempts to bridge the digital divide by providing computers, internet access and training to under-resourced Indian schools. The fellowship helps exchange technical skills, intellectual resources and helps increase the capacity of Indian NGOs to continue their work while giving American leaders a good understanding of India. Ashoka Innovators for the Public. Ashoka Innovators for the Public identifies and supports the world's leading social entrepreneurs. It finds and cultivates social entrepreneurs in every corner of the world whose systems-changing innovations solve deep-rooted social problems. Ashoka Innovators invite them into Ashoka Fellowship, providing early-stage financial support and a lifetime membership into an expansive network of peers and partners, enabling them to achieve their vision and have even greater impact. Ashoka Innovators for the Public is an international organization that promotes social entrepreneurship by affiliating individual social entrepreneurs into the Ashoka organization. Their mission is to shape a global entrepreneurial competitive citizen sector, one that allows social entrepreneurs to thrive and enables the world's Association for the India Development. Association for India's Development is a volunteer movement promoting sustainable, equitable and development. It supports grassroots organizations in India and initiates efforts in various interconnected spheres such as education, livelihoods, natural resources including land, water and energy, agriculture, health, women's empowerment and social justice. The Association for India's Development, AID, is a secularly charity organization based in the United States. AID has won several awards for its work, including the Global Impact Award by the prominent newspaper, The Times of India. AID focuses on a rights-based approach and is in solidarity with prominent people's movements and social workers of India. British High Commission Small Grant Schemes. The United Kingdom's Department for International Development, DFID, makes funds available to the British High Commission for small projects of developmental value. This fund is called Small Grants Scheme, SGS. The United Kingdom gives financial support to small-scale community-based projects through the Small Grant Scheme, which is administered by British High Commission. The main aim of this fund is to deliver transformational policy change and strengthening governance and institutions. The objectives of proposed projects shall match main goals of local embassy. For instance, NGOs working in the Philippines, Palau, Micronesia and the Republic of Marshall Islands are asked to submit proposal for projects aiming to develop capacity building related to key government institutions, and such as they shall focus on policy sharing, policy formulation and the engagement of civil society on the best and most suitable democratic system and structures. It is also important to notice that quite often British embassies organize courses and training to improve managerial skills of local NGO workers. Council for Advancement of People's Action and Rural Technology, CAPART, CAPART. CAPART was formed by amalgamating two agencies and People's Action for Development India. CAPART is an autonomous body registered under the Societies Registration Act 1860 and is functioning under the aegis of Ministry of Rural Development, Government of India. The scheme was formed at that time by merging CART, CART and PADI, which referred to Council for Advancement of Rural Technology and People's Action for Development India, respectively. CAPART, which was once claimed to be a major promoter of rural development in the country, assisting over 12,000 voluntary organizations in implementing a wide range of development initiatives, was slated to be disbanded by the end of UPA 2 term. CARE India. CARE India works for empowerment of women and girls from poor and marginalized communities. It has been working in India for more than 60 years, focusing on ending poverty and social injustice. We do this through well-planned and comprehensive programs in health, education, livelihoods and disaster preparedness and response. CARE India works with the poorest of the poor in more than 100 districts in a total of 11 states across India in 2008. In 2013, CARE India transitioned from an affiliate to a full member of CARE International, a global confederation of member organizations, Austria, Australia, Canada, Denmark, France, Germany, Luxembourg, India, Japan, Netherlands, Norway, Peru, Thailand, United Kingdom and United States, working together to end poverty. Childline India. Childline India is a project of Ministry of Women and Child Development. Childline India Foundation is a non-governmental organization, NGO, in India that operates a telephone helpline called Childline for children in distress. It was India's first 24-hour toll-free phone outreach service for children. It is based in Mumbai. Childline works for the protection of rights of all children aged from 0 to 18 years. Their special focus is on children in need of care and protection, especially the more vulnerable sections. Christian Aid. Christian Aid has supported local organizations in India for more than 50 years, initially providing relief to people affected by natural disasters and now supporting long-term development. Christian Aid is an official relief and development agency of 41 British and Irish churches and works to support sustainable development, stop poverty, support civil society and provide disaster relief in South America, the Caribbean, Africa and Asia, including the Middle East. It works with 570 local partner organizations in 45 countries. It is a major member of Stop Climate Chaos, the Fair Trade Foundation and Trade Justice Movement campaigns. Christian Aid's headquarters are in London and it has regional teams across the UK and Ireland. Christian Aid also organizes UK's largest door-to-door collection, Christian Aid Week, which takes place in May each year. Concern India Foundation. Concern India Foundation was set up in 1991 as a registered non-profit public charitable trust to extend financial and non-financial support to grassroots level NGOs working in the areas of education, health and community development. Its approach is to help people help themselves by making the disadvantaged self-reliant and enabling them to lead a life of dignity. This philosophy lays the foundation for programs so that they have the buy-in of entire community and are hence sustainable and effective. Over the past 25 years, we have strengthened and supported over 1,000 NGO partners across the country through its offices in Mumbai, Bengaluru, Chennai, Delhi, Hyderabad, Kolkata, and Pune. Child Rights and You, CRY. Child Rights and You is a non-profit and non-government organization in India working towards the upliftment of underprivileged children. Child Rights and You, commonly abbreviated as CRY, aims to restore children's rights. The organization was founded in 1979 by Ripon Kapoor. CRY partners with grassroots level non-governmental organizations to uplift thousands of underprivileged Indian children denied of basic rights by working across levels from direct action, advocacy, mobilizing public opinion to policy change. CRY identifies projects across the country and funds the sincere efforts of many individuals and groups who work at a local and regional level and directly interact with the children to ensure happy, healthy and creative childhoods. Department for International Development, DFID. The Department for International Development, DFID, is an United Kingdom government department responsible for administering overseas aid. The goal of the department is to promote sustainable development and eliminate world poverty. DFID's main program areas of work are education, health, social services, water supply and sanitation, government and civil society, economic sector including infrastructure, production sectors and developing planning, environment protection, research and humanitarian assistance. HelpAge India. HelpAge India is a non-profit organization in India caring for disadvantaged elderly senior citizens for more than 3 decades. HelpAge India is a secular, apolitical, non-profit and non-governmental organization in India registered under Societies Registration Act of 1860. Set up in 1978, HelpAge India is a registered national level voluntary organization. Since its foundation, its mission is to work for the cause and care of disadvantaged older persons in order to improve the quality of their lives. HelpAge India began in the late 1960s, but it took 7 years for this vision to take shape. It was so successful that in 1975, HelpAge India International recruited more staff to cover Bombay, Madras, and Calcutta. HelpAge India is one of the founding members of HelpAge International, a high-profile body having 97 member countries representing the cause of the elderly at the United Nations. It is closely associated with Help the Aged, UK, and has received a special testimonial from the United Nations for dedicated service in support of the United Nations Program on Aging. HelpAge India is also a full member of International Federation on Aging. National Bank for Agriculture and Rural Development, NABARD. It is an apex development financial institution in India, headquartered at Mumbai with regional offices all over India. The bank has been entrusted with matters concerning policy, planning and operation in the field of credit for agriculture and other economic activities in rural areas in India. NABARD is an active in developing financial inclusion policy and is a member of Alliance for Financial Inclusion. NABARD has been instrumental in grounding rural social innovations and social enterprises in the rural hinterlands. Oxfam. Oxfam is a confederation of 20 independent charitable organizations focusing on alleviation of global poverty, founded in year 1942 and led by Oxfam International. It is based in Oxford, England. Oxfam is a major non-profit group with an extensive collection of operations. It believes in the right to sustainable livelihood and right to capacity to participate in societies and make positive changes to people's lives as basic human needs and rights which can be met. Plan International India. Plan India is a nationally registered not-for-profit organization striving to advance children's rights and equality for children, thus creating a lasting impact in the lives of vulnerable and excluded children and their communities. Since 1979, Plan India and its partners have improved the lives of millions of children and young people by enabling them to access protection, quality education and healthcare services, a healthy environment, livelihood opportunities and participation in decisions which affect their lives. Plan International is an independent, development and humanitarian organization which works in 71 countries across the world in Africa, the America and Asia to advance children's rights and equality for girls. Plan International is one of the world's largest organizations working for children's rights and gender equality. The organization strives for a just world that promotes children's rights and equality for girls. Next organization, Save the Children. The Save the Children Fund, commonly known as Save the Children, is an international non-governmental organization that promotes children's rights, provides relief and helps support children in developing countries. It was established in United Kingdom in the year 1919 in order to improve the lives of children through better education, healthcare and economic opportunities, as well as providing emergency aid and in natural disasters. The organization promotes policy changes in order to gain more rights for young people, especially by enforcing the UN Declaration of the Rights of the Child. Alliance members coordinate emergency relief efforts, helping them to protect children from the effects of war and violence. Save the Children has general consultative status with the United Nations Economic and Social Council. Sir Dorobji Tata Trust. The Sir Dorobji Tata Trust was established by Sir Dorobji Tata in the year 1932. It is one of the oldest non-sectarian philanthropic organizations in India. The trust offers monetary assistance to students and economically disadvantaged patients, make financial contributions to institutions and provide financial support to non-government organizations in the country. Their vision of constructive philanthropy has been sensitive to the fast-growing needs of the developing nation, and the projects and programs they support bear contemporary relevance. Summary. Fundraising means collect money. There are different sources to get funds to do something. It may be for funding a project, program, service or an activity. These funds can come from a charity organization or a corporate, philanthropist or a foundation. Most non-government organizations, especially social welfare organizations, acquire funds from funding agencies.